Does anyone else's dog suck blankets like this? Taff loves sucking his toys. You're such a baby. You're such a baby sucking that blanket. Hello everybody, and welcome to the Relax My Dog YouTube channel. Today, we're gonna be talking about how to teach your dog to guard. Now, dogs are famously loyal to their owners, which is one of the reasons why they can make such great guard dogs. There are loads of reasons why you might want to teach your dog to guard. Whether it's for protecting livestock or protecting your house from home intruders, it's a really useful skill to teach your dog. So today we're going to give you a few tips on how to get started. But before we get started, let us know in the comments, do you think your dog would be a good guard dog? Taff does like to have a bit of a bark at strangers outside, but honestly he's such a softie and a big wuss that I don't think he'd have much of an impact. So the first thing you want to do is introduce your dog to the territory you want them to guard. So you can do this by walking them around the perimeter and the border of the territory you want them to guard and making sure you let them feel like it's their own. This could mean things like throwing toys along the border, letting them go to the toilet, just anything that makes them feel like they're kind of claiming it. Once they have an area established as their own, they'll start to develop a natural urge to guard that territory. Also keep in mind that some dog breeds are just naturally better suited to being guard dogs than other breeds. So if you're looking to get a dog specifically to guard, something like a German Shepherd or a Doberman is probably going to do a much better job than something like a Golden Retriever. Then you want to start introducing the idea of actively protecting. So the methods for this are a little bit different depending on whether you want your dog to be protecting your house or livestock, so we'll go over both. So first let's do livestock, for example chickens. You want your dog to spend a lot of time around the chickens to the point that they come pretty much desensitized to them. You also want to keep a really close eye on your dog and make sure you instantly praise any kind of behaviour that resembles protecting the chickens, especially if that's chasing off wild animals that come too close. Whenever you see a wild animal approaching the chickens, make a really big fuss of chasing it off and making loads of noise, because dogs love to mimic their owners, and seeing you do these kind of actions will help them understand what they need to do. Teaching your dog to bark on command can also be a really useful idea, as it makes it much easier to encourage them to bark to scare off wild animals that come too close. Next, for home invaders and trespassers. The first thing you want to do is find a willing stranger to help you train. It's important that you find a stranger so your dog understands that they're guarding from unfamiliar people, not people in your family. The main part of the training now is praising your dog for barking at the stranger. This is a fairly natural reaction for dogs anyway, so a lot of the time it will be kind of having the stranger knock on the door or the window, waiting for your dog to bark or react, and then praising them as soon as they do. Again, if you teach your dog to bark on command, you can also have a little more control over the situation. For example, whenever the stranger walks past your window, you can encourage the dog to bark, give him the command, and then praise them instantly. And this will lead him to associate the person walking past that window or doing that specific action with him needing to bark. This can be really useful if you have a really specific layout or a specific idea of what you want your dog to do. This is a really good way of encouraging them to do that without just kind of waiting for them to react naturally. Now, guarding is a great skill to teach your dog and it's really useful for a lot of people, but there is the potential that if they're not trained properly, your dog could develop some antisocial behaviours that cause a lot of trouble. Always make sure you can call your dog off, even if they're in the middle of guarding, it's really important that you can call them away, and never encourage your dog to bite or attack people unless you have a very qualified trainer to help you with that. So that is everything for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed, and we hope you learned something about training your dog to guard. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to leave a like and a comment, and subscribe to the Relax My Dog YouTube channel for loads more doggy content going up all the time. We are going to head off now, and we'll see you next time. Bye!